You gotta go to the slides.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Delavan United Methodist Church, being Vida, Abundante Church, together. We're here to celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ. Merry Christmas to all of you. Thank you for being here and your pastor, Angel Rosario. And we are so glad to have you here this evening. If this is your first time with us, we want to welcome you and to let you know that we're so glad that you chose us today to be part of your Christmas Eve experience. Thank you very much for being here. Our goal is for today, as we go home, we'll go home encouraged by the birth of our Jesus Christ, and that you go home with your faith lifted up and that your heart be filled with the hope, joy, peace of God, and the love, the so amazing love that he got for us this evening. Gracias a todos y a todas por estar con nosotros en la iglesia de Delavan, la iglesia Vida Abundante, le da la más cordial bienvenida. Y si esa es tu primera vez con nosotros, le damos la gracia por estar con nosotros. Este es un hermoso día que el Señor ha preparado y queremos que hoy el Señor le llene su corazón de la alegría, el gozo, la paz que solamente Él da y de su amor abundante. At this time, before we continue, I just want to make a small change that we're going to have today. In our first song, Joy to the World, because of some technical difficulties, we're going to sing it all in English. Although it says there is Spanish and English, so I will encourage that you grab one of the hymnals in front of you and the pews. It's hymn number 246. And we'll sing all four verses in English. Alright? That's the only announcement I have for today, so I'd like to for all of you to bow your head and let us commit ourselves to the Lord in prayer. Father God, I want to thank you, Lord, for giving us this wonderful day. This wonderful day that you have for us. All the blessings that you have in store for us. We claim those blessings. We thank you, God, for the amazing love that you have for each and every one of us. Father, we're here to celebrate Jesus. We're here to celebrate the joy of Christmas. We're here, Father God, to come together as one. Brothers, sisters, all together are here in one voice to worship you, God, to worship you, Jesus. Thank you for this amazing and wonderful gift that you have given us and continue to give us love, an overwhelming love. Thank you, God, for all that you have already prepared for each and every one of us. We ask, Holy Spirit, that your presence be in this place. Father, as we sing, fill our heart with your love. Fill our heart with your hope and peace. In the name of Jesus Christ, may we go out of this place encouraged from your word, from your love, Lord. May we go home encouraged to tell others about your amazing love. In the name of Jesus Christ, Padre, pedimos que tu presencia esté con cada uno de nosotros. Que tú nos ayudes en esta tarde a poder adorar tu nombre. Gracias por el regalo de Jesús haber nacido hace más de 2,000 años atrás. Cuando ese niño nació, nació la paz, nació el amor, nació el gozo, nació la alegría. Padre, te pedimos en el nombre de Jesús que tu Espíritu Santo en esta hora pueda ayudarnos a adorar tu nombre. Que tu Espíritu Santo tome el control de cada parte que hagamos. Que a través de estas alabanzas podamos sentir tu amor, tu gozo, tu paz, la alegría. En el nombre de Jesús te lo pedimos todo y te damos gracias.
Jesus.
Thank you. Oh, God, here we go.
Decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this,
an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph, son of David," the angel said, "do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophet: "Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." When Joseph woke up, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded and took Mary as his wife. But he did not have sexual relations with her until her son was born. And Joseph named him Jesus. Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the reign of King Herod. About that time, some wise men from the eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star as it rose, and we have come to worship him." King Herod was deeply disturbed when he heard this, as was everyone in Jerusalem. He called a meeting of the leading priests and teachers of the religious law and asked, "Where is the Messiah supposed to be born?" "In Bethlehem in Judea," they said. "For this is what the prophet wrote: And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not least among the ruined cities of Judah, for a ruler will come to you who will be the shepherd for my people Israel." When Herod called for a private meeting with the wise men, he learned from them the time when the star first appeared. Then he told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me so, that I can go and worship him too." After this interview, the wise men went their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure chests and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. When it was time to leave, they returned to their own country by another route, for God had warned them in a dream not to return to Herod. The word of the Lord.
Durante el reinado de Herodes. Por ese tiempo, algunos sabios de países del Oriente llegaron a Jerusalén y preguntaron, ¿dónde está el rey de los judíos que acaba de nacer? Vimos su estrella mientras salía y hemos venido a verlo. Cuando el rey Herodes oye eso, se perturbó profundamente, igual que todos en Jerusalén. Mandó llamar a los principales sacerdotes y maestros de la religiosa y les preguntó, ¿dónde se supone que nacerá el Mesías? En Belén de Judea, le dijeron, porque eso es lo que escribió el profeta. Y tú, oh Belén, en la tierra de Judá, no eres el menor entre las ciudades reinantes de Judá, porque de ti saldrá un gobernante, que será el pastor de mi pueblo Israel. Luego Herodes convocó a los sabios a una reunión privada, y por medio de ellos se enteró el momento en el que había aparecido la estrella por primera vez. Entonces les dijo, vayan a Belén y busquen al niño con esmero. Cuando lo encuentren, vuelvan y díganme dónde está para que yo también vaya y lo adore. Después de esa reunión, los sabios siguieron su camino, y la estrella que habían visto en el oriente los guió hasta Belén. Iba delante de ellos y se detuvo sobre el lugar donde estaba el niño. Cuando vieron la estrella, se llenaron de alegría. Entraron en la casa y vieron al niño con su madre, María, y se inclinaron y lo adoraron. Luego abrieron sus cofres de tesoro y le dieron regalos de oro, incienso y mirra. Cuando llegó el momento de irse, volvieron a su tierra por otro camino, ya que Dios les advirtió en un sueño que no regresarán a Herodes. Esa es palabra de Dios.
Thank you.
one more time, I welcome all of you and thank you for being here tonight. You may wonder, wow, so many songs, so many things we're singing. Well, it was purposely done that way because we are celebrating Jesus. That is Christmas. Christmas is all about Jesus. And Jesus is, it's to be worshipped. And how else are we going to worship Jesus but with song and praises? So that's why today we're celebrating Jesus by singing and just giving him all the glory and honor. So usted se estará preguntando, ¿por qué tantas canciones? ¿Por qué tanta música? Pues así fue que lo programamos porque estamos celebrando a Jesús. Estamos celebrando el día en que nuestro Señor nació. ¿Y qué otra forma que adorar al Señor con canciones y alabanzas? Well, I would like for you to give me about 10 minutes. I'm just going to take some time to just to speak to you a word. Necesito que me des solamente como algunos 10 minutos porque quiero darte unas palabras. And this is just a small reflection. And today I titled this The Best Gift of All Time. The Best Gift of All Time. Es una pequeña reflexión que le he titulado El Mejor Regalo de Todos los Tiempos. I don't know if you have ever some Christmas going crazy trying to find the best gift to give to either your spouse or your kids or somebody that you love, and you go around and you go to the store and this isn't it, I don't think she will like what he will like that, and you're frustrated because you never find a perfect gift. Until almost at the last minute, maybe you find something and then you say, this is perfect. Yes. Yo no sé si en algún momento usted se ha frustrado tratando de buscar un regalo perfecto para su esposa, para su esposo, para sus hijos, y va a la tienda y busca y no, este no es, o va para el otro lado y dice, no, este no es, o no es tampoco, hasta que de momento se encuentra con el regalo perfecto. Y usted dice, este es el regalo. So when you find that gift, you feel proud of yourself and you say, this is the best gift of all time. I gave my wife a new car. She doesn't know that I bought a boat too. I'm just kidding. Usted diga, ese es el mejor regalo. Le regalé a mi esposa un coche tremendo, un carro tremendo. Porque ella no sabía que también yo me compré un bote. But I want to challenge your perspective today. And I want to give you a different perspective about gift. And then, after this reflection, after this sermon, you will let me know if you have outgiven Jesus in his gifts. So I want to turn into Philippians chapter 2, verse 6 and 7. It's not going to be in the screen, so you have to listen. Philippians chapter 2, verse 6 and 7 says, though he was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to. Instead, he gave up his divine privilege. He took the humble position as a slave and was born as a human being when he appeared in human form. So hoy yo quiero retarle. Y después del sermón, yo quiero que usted me reflexione a ver si su regalo, el mejor regalo de todos los tiempos, va a ser mejor que el regalo de Jesús. Se encuentra en Filipenses, capítulo 2, versos 6 al 7. Aunque era Dios, no consideró que el ser igual a Dios fuera algo a lo cual aferrarse. En cambio, renunció a sus privilegios divinos y adoptó la humilde posición de un esclavo, y nació como un ser humano cuando apareció en forma de hombre. So to this date, no one knows exactly Jesus' birth date. We celebrate the 25th of December as Christ's birth, but no one knows exactly when was his exact date. It is to believe that it was somewhere ending of September, beginning of October, right by the fall. But it is not as important to know when Jesus was born, but what it cost for him to be born in a human form. I call this from being a majesty to be born in a manger. Hasta la fecha nadie sabe cuándo fue que nació Jesús. Celebramos el día 25 de diciembre como la fecha que Jesús nació, pero nadie sabe. Y se cree que fue entre el final de septiembre y el principio de octubre. Pero no es importante saber la fecha cuando Jesús nació, lo que es importante es conocer lo que le costó a Jesús. Y esto yo lo llamo de su majestad a un humilde pesebre. The word of God says today in Philippians, though he, meaning Jesus, though Jesus was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to. Instead, he gave up his divine privilege. El libro de Filipenses dice que aunque él, Jesús, aunque él era Dios, él no pensó en igualdad con Dios como algo a lo que aferrarse, sino que entregó sus privilegios divinos. Let me translate you this a little bit simpler. Jesus traded equally, or I don't think it's even equally. Jesus traded his riches, comfort, and glory for pain, suffering, and death. What Paul is saying to the Philippians, Jesus traded his glory, his riches, his comfort, his kingdom, and he gave all that up, traded for pain, suffering, and death. And all that because of love. All of that is because he wanted to give you and me eternal life with him. Déjame traducirte un poquito lo que Pablo está diciendo a los filipenses. Pablo está diciendo que Jesús cambió su riqueza, su comodidad, su gloria por dolor, sufrimiento y muerte. Y todo eso lo hizo por amor a usted. Todo eso lo hizo para darte a ti vida eterna. Dime si eso no es una cosa asombrosa. So Jesus traded his riches, comfort, and glory for death, for pain and suffering, all so you and I can have eternal life. Tell me that is not amazing. No wonder we sing Amazing Love. Because it is amazing. Imagine a king giving up his kingdom and becoming a slave just to save our lives. Not only he gave up his royal privilege, instead of being born in a royal crib, in a family with thousands of millions of dollars, our God, our Lord, decided to just be humble and be born, not even in a crib, in a manger, where all the cows and horses eat from it. Something that is not important. Our King of Kings, our Jesus Christ, traded his kingdom for a manger. And all because he loves you. Imagínense a un rey que renuncia a su reino y se convierte en un esclavo para salvar nuestra vida. No solo renunció a los privilegios reales, sino que nació en un humilde pesebre. ¿Qué otro rey hace eso? Que un rey de reyes, teniendo sus riquezas y teniendo todo, que quizás podía haber nacido en una cuna de oro, decidió nacer en un pesebre donde los caballos, las vacas, donde los animales comen. And then Paul continues saying, God itself, being a king, took the humble position of a slave and was born a human being. The best Christmas gift that happened over 2,000 years ago was when a divine king came from a majesty to be born in a manger. As a human form, he suffered and he died and was raised from the dead. And from the manger, he went back to a majesty. All that to give you and me the best gift of all time. And it's called salvation. Over 2,000 years ago, Jesus was born. And he grew up to be a man that changed thousands of lives and made miracles that brought hope, joy, peace, and love to the world. And at the end of his life, 33 years old, they counted all that as garbage, and he nailed them to a cross and said he was a criminal. But on that cross, he had a choice to say, you know what, I am God. I don't need to be here. I'm going to get out of here. And he could do that. But he chose to die to give you and me eternal life. El mejor regalo de todos los tiempos nació hace 2,000 años atrás. Cuando este rey divino vino de ser su majestad para nacer en un pesebre en forma humana. Él sufrió, murió, resucitó de entre los muertos. Y de un pesebre vino a ser otra vez majestad. Todo eso para darte a ti y a mí el mejor regalo de todos los tiempos que se llama salvación. Es la salvación. Este rey tenía la opción de salirse de aquella cruz. Después que él nació y estuvo en el pesebre, después que él creció y sanó a mucha gente, hizo milagros, salvó a cientos de miles de personas, trajo amor, esperanza, gozo, paz, alegría, la gente lo clavaron en una cruz como un criminal. Y en esa cruz él podría haber decidido salir, pero él decidió quedarse y morir para completar la profecía, para darnos a nosotros la vida eterna. Let me finish with this. If you look at your bulletin, you will not find a place where the offerings are. Yes, you're right. There is no offering. And normally a church likes offerings on Christmas Eve. But not this year. You know what? Because instead of giving money to the church, we're not looking for money. As a pastor, I'm not looking for money. I am more worried and more, I care more for your heart. And in this time of Christmas, we're so used to just go and buy gifts for our loved ones and trade gifts that we forget about the birthday boy that is Jesus. So why have you gotten to Jesus? You thought about giving something to Jesus. So today, I want to challenge you that instead of giving any monetary offering to the church, why don't you give your heart to Christ today? Why don't you say, Jesus, forgive me, because I've done all this wrong. Christmas is not about giving gifts to everyone. Christmas is all about Jesus. It's about Him. The day that he was born, joy was born. The day that he was born, peace was born. The day that he was born, hope was born. More importantly, love was born. That will be the best gift you have ever given. Jesus doesn't need AirPods or tablets or a phone or a TV. He doesn't need none of that. In fact, he doesn't need anything. He got it all. But what he would really want would be your heart. Now, I challenge you to give your heart to Christ today. And if you still want to give the monetary offering to the church, we still got the offering plate in the back after service. If you want to put something in there, you can. But I would like for you to give your heart to Christ and give your best gift of all time to the birthday boy Jesus. Fíjense, si usted se da cuenta, usted no va a ver en el boletín ninguna parte donde hay una ofrenda monetaria. No vamos a colectar las ofrendas. Porque a veces estamos tan enfocados en darle ofrenda a la iglesia o en compartir un regalo con las personas que más amamos, que se nos olvida regalarle al niño que cumple año en esta temporada, que es Jesús. Y en vez de dar una ofrenda monetaria a la iglesia, yo quisiera que usted le diera su corazón al Señor como regalo. Ese regalo de su corazón será el mejor regalo de todos los tiempos. Jesús no necesita audífonos, Jesús no necesita tabletas, Jesús no necesita teléfonos, Jesús no necesita una televisión de 4K ni nada de eso. Él no necesita un automóvil o una bicicleta. De hecho, Él no necesita nada. Pero lo que sí Él desearía en su corazón es que usted entregue su corazón a Él hoy. Pero si aún así usted desea dar una ofrenda monetaria a la iglesia, después del servicio, a la parte de atrás, tenemos un plato, usted puede dar su ofrenda, si así lo desea. Pero no se vaya de aquí hoy sin darle su corazón al Señor. So the best gift of all time would be your heart to Christ. I encourage you today to give the best that you have for our Lord Jesus Christ, and that is your heart. And if you do, I guarantee you that in the darkest of the moments in your life, the darkest moments in your life, will be lightened up by the light of Christ, because you have given Him your heart. So, will you please bow your head and pray? Vamos a tomar un tiempo de oración. Dios Todopoderoso, Father God, we come to you this morning. This evening. And we thank you, Lord, for the things that you have done in our life. Gracias, Dios, por las cosas que tú has hecho en nuestra vida. And God, I want to thank you for the scripture today. Señor, te quiero dar la gracia por tu palabra, Lord. I want to give you thanks because you have been the best gift of all time for all of us. Gracias porque tú has sido el mejor regalo para nosotros de todos los tiempos. So today, I want to give you my best. The best gift that I can give to you is my heart. So Dios, el mejor regalo que yo puedo darte hoy es mi corazón. So I surrender my heart to you, God. And I pray for my brothers and sisters that are here today. As they pray, and as they surrender their heart to you, Father, may you receive that. May you bring peace, hope, joy, and love to every heart present in this place. Padre, mientras mis hermanos y hermanas en este lugar están orando, te pido que tú tomes su corazón y que tú traigas a este corazón gozo, paz, alegría, amor. Que es el mejor regalo que nosotros te podemos dar en el corazón. Father, may this Christmas be a different Christmas. May our family members come together. Father, may joy, the joy that you bring to our lives, may be transferred from us to our family member. I ask, Father God, that forgiveness may come through this joy. I ask, Father God, that any broken relationships right now are being healed in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Lord, as we give your heart, may you enlighten our days and our lives. I pray in Jesus' name. Señor, mientras oramos, te pido, Dios, que seas tú sanando las relaciones rotas. Que el gozo y la paz que trae tu amor, Señor, a nuestro corazón pueda sanar esas relaciones rotas en estos días. En el nombre de Jesús te lo pido todo. Amén. Amén.
This night is a night to remember, a night when home broke in on us, a night when we were not forgotten or alone or abandoned. This night. This night is the night when here and there became one, when past and future combined in a breathless present. This is a night where we are home, in ourselves, in this family, in the God who loved us enough to walk beside us.
We gather in the night to protect, to proclaim the light. We shrug off our despair and embrace our hope. We set aside conflict and choose peace. We push away despair by becoming joy. We overcome our hate by rising into love, because this night we know, even in the shadows of our doubts, we know that we are loved. That's what it means to be home.
We light these candles, hoping to become the light, hoping to radiate light by how we live. We light these candles to create a space called home in this place, in our place, and in your places. We light these candles to declare that unto us the Savior is born, who is Christ the Lord. Welcomed home by angels singing and shepherds kneeling. Welcomed home by those like us who have worshipped for thousands of years. Welcomed home again tonight, right here, right now, in us.
It's time to be home.
Quinta vela de Cristo. El color blanco tiene a simbolizar la pureza de Cristo, mostrando la inocencia de Cristo. No es sorprendente que la vela de Cristo represente a Cristo y el papel que desempeña en la historia de la vida. Jesús trajo luz al mundo a través de su llegada a la tierra cuando era un bebé. No podemos ser cristianos sin Cristo. De lo contrario, nuestras obras y nuestro propósito en la tierra son en vano. Necesitamos a Cristo y el amor de Cristo para compartir las buenas nuevas de la salvación en toda la tierra. Cristo conecta todas las velas de Adviento a través de Él. Podemos tener esperanza, gozo, amor y paz. Sin Él, ¿por qué tener esas cosas? Cristo desciende a las tinieblas para iluminar el mundo. Gracias a Él, podemos ser una luz para los demás, mostrándoles el verdadero significado de la vida. Que viva la esperanza, el amor, el gozo y la paz. Que viva Cristo, que viva el Rey. Cristo es la razón de la Navidad. Cristo es la razón de nuestras vidas.
At this time, we would like for everyone to stand up. We're going to be lighting up the candles. And how we're going to do this, the ushers are going to come and light up the first person in the pew. And for the first person, you can share your light to the person next to you. Ahora los pianos van a venir a prender la vela y la primera persona de la banca va a prender su vela y esa persona la va a compartir con las personas de al lado. After all the lights are lit, then we will sing Silent Night. After the song, everyone is welcome to leave. We'll not have a benediction until Sunday.
I don't want anybody to trip.